Dear English literature learners, I'd like to give some idea on questions and answers on English literature, early and middle English period, 450 to 1350, part B. This video is confined to short questions with answers on the early English period. My next video will be on short question answers on the middle English period, part B, short questions with answers. Early English period, 450 to 1066. Question 1. Write a short note on Anglo-Saxon period. Answer. Originally, the name Anglo-Saxon denotes two of three Germanic tribes, Jutes, Angles, and Saxons, who in the middle of the 5th century left their homes on the shores of the North Sea and the Baltic to conquer and colonize distant Britain. Later in that century, the Angles and Saxons took over the lion's share of the island of Britain. By 700, they occupied the parts of Great Britain, which Roman had made part of their empire. This part became known as Anglo-Lent, the land of the Angles, and its language was English. Therefore, the Old English or Anglo-Saxon literature appears to be the origin of English literature. The authorship of most of its literature is unknown. Only one or two names are known. The English poem composed by Caedmon and Bede are the earliest we know of. Their manuscripts were hard to read. Very little were read between Middle Ages and in the reign of Queen Victoria. Therefore, Old English literature is a part of English literature. The Angles, the Saxon, and the Jews were illiterate. Their orally composed verses were not written. Unless they were formed a runic inscription, it seems that the first English poetry resembles heroic poetry. As classical literature begins with Homer's epic, so does early English literature begin with Beowulf. The orally composed poetry of the Anglo-Saxon was established out. Question 2. Write a short note on Beowulf. Answer. Of the old English poetry, Beowulf is the most remarkable. Like Greek literature, English literature begins with an epic. It is a poem of historic scope, telling of heroes and of the world, human and non-human. It is the longest and richest of old English poems. Beowulf showed the English the world of their ancestors, the heroic world of their past. The date and provenance of Beowulf are uncertain. Its author is unknown. The text of the Beowulf is found in a manuscript in a West Saxon dialect of Wessex, which became the literary standard. All the texts are about monster, but the prime concern of Beowulf is not with monsters or even heroes, but with human wisdom and destiny. There are many episodes and digressions in the story of Beowulf. It is impossible to give a brief synopsis of the narrative. In outline, it can be said that Beowulf, son of Ithiel, sails to Denmark with a band of warriors and rids the Danish king, Rutger, of a terrible monster called Grendel. The mother of Grendel, seeking revenge for the death of her son, meets the same fate. Beowulf was rewarded and returned to his native land. He becomes the king of Geatos, and after a prosperous reign of some 40 years, he kills a dragon which ravaged his land, but in the fight, he received a mortal wound. The poem concludes with a funeral ceremony in honor of the dead hero. Question 3. Write a short note on the Dream of the Rood. Answer. The Dream of the Rood is undoubtedly the finest of all English religious poems. It is a story of crucifixion told by the cross itself. In his dream, the poet sees the miraculous tree by turns, shining in jewels and bathed in blood. It relates to him the story of his life from that day when it was struck down on the birds of the forest to that on which the young hero was lifted on to it. The dreamer in this poem sees at midnight a glorious cross rise to fill the sky, worshipped by all creation. It is covered with gold and jewels, but at other times covered with blood. It is honored by man as beacon light and a cure for all ills of life. This poem has religious overtone. It is allegorical, meaning influenced with the later medieval school of allegorical poetry. The poem also presents the warrior culture of the past. In warrior culture, it was the duty of a man to study, to stand by his lord, and to die in his defense. But the lord in the dream is an Anglo-Saxon hero who wants to join battle with death. In a devotional conclusion, the cross explains that it is now honored as a sign of salvation and commands the dreamer to tell man the Christian news of the second coming, when those who live under the sign of cross will be saved. Therefore, we can say the poem shows Old English liturgical tradition, the story of crucifixion. In other words, it fills the living culture with theology and redirecting the heroic code of loyalty and sacrifice from an earthly to heavenly lord. Question 4. What do you know about Caedmon? Answer. Anglo-Saxon religious poetry is the work of two Christian poets who were monks, Caedmon and Cynulf. They were the representative poets of English Christian poetry. Caedmon flourished in the last quarter of the 7th century. He was the first man to sign about Christianity systematically. He was supposed to have written 4 poems, Genesis, Exodus, Daniel, and Christian Chatham. All the subjects are taken from the Bible. Genesis is a poem of God and angels in heaven, of a rebellion of angels and their fall, of creation of earth and man. Exodus is the story of the marshalling of Pharaoh's hosts and the pursuit of Moses and his men. Daniel deals with the first 5 chapters of the book of Daniel. Krish and Satan deals with the lament of the fallen angels, harrowing of hell, and the temptation of Christ. Caedmon's poems are sometimes paraphrases of the stories of the Bible. They're strong and spirited with the gift of descriptive writing. Question 5. Who is Cynulf? Why is he famous poet? Cynulf is an important Christian poet of the Anglo-Saxon religious poetry. He was a writer of great influence and poet of genuine power. He is the first poet in the English language to sign his works in runic letter. His important poems are Juliana, Christ, the Fates of the Apostles, and Ellen. Juliana is about a female Christian saint who refuses to marry a Roman prefect and so suffers persecutions. Christ's birth, ascension, and the day of judgment. The fate of apostles is on the lives of 12 apostles of Christ. Ellen has for its subjects the finding of the cross. The poem attributed to Cynulf are Andreas. The dream of Rud, Phoenix, Gutlech. Among these, the dream of Rud is the finest of the Anglo-Saxon Christian poetry. Question 6. Write a short note on King Alfred. Answer. King Alfred is claimed to be the father of English prose. Alfred, when he became the king of Wessex, found his people of the country ignorant. After establishing peace and order in the country, he applied himself to the task of educating the people. He supervised the translation of many related books into English prose. The five important translations, either done by himself or under his guidance, are pastoral care of Pope George Gregory, are the History of the World by Orosius, Bede's Ecclesiastical History, Boethius's Consolation of Philosophy, and the Soliloquies of St. Augustine. Anglo-Saxon Chronicles was his masterpiece. It is the first historical work in English. It is a record of the death of the king, beginning of Caesar, and his installation of bishops. It is the oldest document of English prose, recording the history of England from the time of Roman occupation to the middle of 12th century. In fact, after defeating the Danes king, Alfred tried to improve the lamentable state of English learning. He not only translated, but also encouraged and rewarded learned men. He has become a patron of his scholars. His translation made great contribution to literature. In rigorous style, Alfred's prose style was highly Latinized. Question 7, who is Alfric? Answer, Alfric was probably the best known writer for his grammar. He was a churchman who has become the abbot of Benedictine monastery. He wrote musical prose among his work. The best important are the Catholic homilies, the lives of saints. These are translations from the scriptures. His style is natural and easy, and it has poetic quality. Question 8, who is Wulfstan? Answer, Wulfstan was the Archbishop of York. Many of his saint homilies survived. His most famous work is Sermo Lupiat Anglos. It is important for his strength and vigor, repetition of ideas, and illustrative nature of his style. Wulfstan teaches as a preacher, where as Alfred teaches as a teacher. Both of them use rhyme and alliteration in their works. Question 9. What is the want error? Answer. The want error is an Old English lyric. The poem narrates the story of a man who has lost his lord and wanders and mourns his lost glory and happiness. The wanderer laments over the meaninglessness, death and decay of earthly glory and beauty. He learns that sufferings dominates earthly life and thus seeks mercy and comfort from the Father in heaven. The poem expresses Christian consolation. Its melancholic tone has a touch of universality about it. Question 10. What is the seafarer? Answer. The seafarer is a dramatic lyric with melancholic tone. It combines the element of regret and self-pity. It is a monologue of an old mariner who remembers the dangers at sea. And at the same time, is impressed by the fascination of life at sea. The poem is called to suffering, toil, privation. It represents the rigidity of Christian life. Question 11. What is the wife's complaint? Answer. It is a dramatic monologue and at the same time a love poem. The wife has been separated from her husband, forced to live in a forest. The note of personal passion, love and longing for her husband, her lamentation finds an eloquent expression in his poem. The wife expresses her grief and feeling of separation in this poem. Question 12. What is the husband's message? Answer. The poem, Husband's Message, makes use of rhetorical device, which is found in classical literature. Here, the speaker is a piece of wood on which the letter is carved. It tells the wife its own life story and then speaks of the message written on it. The husband reminds his wife of his promises made to her. He tells her now, and he tells her how he has been separated from her by a quarrel. He makes rapturous exhortation to her to join him across the sea. The poem seems to be a sequel to the wife's complaint. It is a love poem as well as a dramatic monologue. Question 13. Write a short note on Anglo-Saxon Chronicle. Answer. Anglo-Saxon Chronicle is often called an Old English Annals because it consists of four distinct chronicles preserved in different manuscripts. The compiler was probably a clergy in King Alfred's services who used various sources like earlier annalistic matter, genealogy, bits ecclesiastical history, and oral reports. The chronicle reports the contemporary events of 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th century. The chronicle gives us list of events, not narrative accounts. Therefore, the Anglo-Saxon Chronicle is important from historical point of view. It contains the information of early English history. Thank you for watching. I'm Shamim Sarwar. My next video is on the short questions and answers on Middle English period, part B. Have a nice day.